say it like that. If I hate you, then find someone new. Maybe, but you know I never will. No, so I choke you down just like a pill.
And welcome to another episode of Artsy Fartsy Friday. Hopefully you guys can all hear me well enough. We're going to make sure we can also still hear the music a little bit. But yeah, this is going to be a little different because hopefully I'm streaming on both Facebook and YouTube right now. And we're going to do a little transition. Hi, how's it going? Hope everybody's doing well. Let's see. Yay! Liz is telling me we both have both Facebook and YouTube. All right, so Lissa, you know what to do. Let's share that thing around, shall we? And I've set things up a little bit differently today. We're gonna turn me up a little bit more. Boom. Hopefully that's good enough. I hope everybody can hear me. La da 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 da. Test. Alright. Here we go. So I've set things up a little bit differently today. We're gonna try something a little new. So everybody who's posting all your comments, you should be able to see them again. But I formatted this a little bit differently. Here comes the new format. Boom! Oh, so now you guys can see this a little bit bigger. Hopefully the quality's a little bit nicer. And you guys should hopefully be able to get this in and see more of what I'm doing. You can see me in the top corner this time. And all of your comments should be able to go below right here, right below me. So go ahead and start putting up whatever, and we'll see if the comments are working. And let's get started, shall we? So as usual, make sure you have all of your normal stuff for Artsy Fartsy Friday. You got your paints, all of your paints. I use acrylics, and it's just mostly what I have around. I have watercolors and stuff, but I don't really use them that much. Plus, I'm not really too familiar as much with acrylics. Let me turn this light on here. There we go. So make sure you guys got your paints. I use just basic paints. These are all from Apple Barn. They're not sponsored or anything like that. These are just pretty inexpensive. Anybody can get them pretty much anywhere. Amazon, eBay, Walmart, all that jazz. Make sure you guys have your brushes, all of your brushes. I've got, these are just generic brushes. I play around with these to see what works best. For whatever I'm painting today. Got my cups and everything over here. Got my cups of water for my paint. And I've got my little tray to put all my paint stuff on. My little, I don't know what you call it. Just a paint tray, I guess. Hello, Anthony. My son is holding me up with clothes. Nope, not right now. I'm going to have to give you money later. Ransom me for money later. All right. Let's see here. What's next? So paints, waters, all that jazz. Yeah. So I was trying to figure out what I'm going to be painting today. I'm not really sure. Hey, Cole. Yes, testing. Yeah, you're there's your comments right there, buddy. Thanks for joining in. It should be able to pop up where you're commenting on. I think you're commenting from the Facebook, if it serves correctly. But yeah, let's see here. Some people have been telling me they want fish. So I know Cole has said he wants to see some koi. Somebody said some koi in space. Anytime I'm looking at koi, I don't want to do a whole bunch of them. I don't even know if I'm going to be good at doing koi. Maybe I'll be coy about dry koi? Huh? Huh? Space. Lissa, is that you posting on our own archetype? Do space. I think that's Lissa posting on our own archetype. Because that ain't me. That's for sure. Do some modern art. What is modern art? What modern art am I going to do? I'm not sure what I mean, what I'm going to do for my modern art. Headphones. hold on. I'm gonna turn my microphone down a little bit real quick. I need to blow my nose, and my nose gets... I get loud when I blow my nose, okay? It's the nose trumpet, as my girlfriend's kids call it. So I'm going to turn it down for you guys in just a minute. Oh, them allergies. Oh, them allergies. All right, so I think I'm going to do koi in space. We're going to see how that turns out. So we're going to do a variety of different blacks and blues and purples, I think. And I'm thinking I'm going to make the koi kind of a yin-yang. So it's sort of modern-ish. Sort of. I don't know. We're gonna play with it. I don't even know if I can do koi fish. I haven't done fish. I sort of did okay with smog last Friday, but we'll see. All right, we'll see. We'll see how this works out. But first, as we do as always, everything is layers, and we're gonna shake up our paints. We're gonna shake it up. Shake up the paints. Space koi. That's right, space koi. That was from what's her name? Chloe, Mike White's girlfriend. I think she's his girlfriend. I could have just misspoken. Sorry, Chloe, if you're not, but hooray if you are. Anyways, all right. Let's get this space koi going. So we're gonna start with our blacks here. Actually, you know what? I think I'm gonna do. Oh. That's a glob of black paint that's got stuck on the top there. But let's go ahead and pour out our black. I think we'll even add some like purples and stuff to this because it is space, right? And then the stars and things, and then we'll paint the koi on top of the space, right? Maybe that's what I'm thinking. And I'm gonna take a little bit of water. Because somebody taught me a trick that if I put a little bit of water to my paint, it'll spread a little easier. Aww. I learn things as I do this. I don't know if you guys can hear the music. Listen, let me know if they can hear the music okay. Because it's sort of intense. Alright, we've got a big group of black there. I don't want that black to split in. So, here we go. Remember, I put a little bit of water, and we're just doing the base right now. Because we do layers, like ogres, everybody. Everybody remembers ogres? Ogres are like layers. Or onions. Ogres are like onions. Yeah, ogres are like onions. Okay. So we're doing space koi today. We're just putting down the base of our space. And we're gonna add some different colors. There will be purple today for all of you purple fans out there. You need to add a little bit more water just to make it spread a little better. If it's gonna be that intense. No, I think I'll just leave the Liss is messaging me. No, I think I'll leave the audio levels where they're at if everything sounds good. Lissa, if everything sounds where it should be, I'll just leave it where it's at. If that sounds good to you, my online marketing and producer. Lissa has also been producing the live streams a lot lately for Axanar, if you guys are Star Trek fans out there. Ooh, getting a little runny on the water. Maybe I put a little too much water. But that's okay. It's just the base. If you don't dry brush the paint. Also, if you don't dry brush paint, it helps.
Yes. I figured that out now, Lissa. I should probably make it to where I can see everybody's comments, besides it being on the side of the screen where I can't really look at it. So, anyways, how's everybody doing today? I hope you're all doing well.
Hope your artsy fartsiness has been going good for all those artsy fartsy people out there. Okay. Not right now, Anthony. You'll have to show me later, buddy. My son likes to update me on his latest artsy fartsy artworks, which he is really good at. Mostly he's more drawing and stuff and using the digital stuff, but and doing his animations as well. He has some very remarkable animations. Maybe if that, you know what, we'll do that. If you guys want to see some cool animations that my son makes, if we can get the channel, but like YouTube or whatever, if we can get like 100 likes, the day we get 100 likes on YouTube and Facebook combined, whatever. The day we get 100 likes, I will share with you guys my son's animations, and they are really good. For any of those who have seen it, you can attest that my son's animations are decently well done for an 11-year-old, especially. Like, if he decides to continue that path of animation, I completely support that. I support his artsy fartsiness and all artsy fartsiness, whether it's animation or music or whatever. Yeah. La 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 la. Because art is not just limited to paints. Or in my case, what I really love is film. That's my main passion. So hopefully that shows in my artsy fartsiness on what I paint. And how you guys view everything. This is gonna be an interesting space. It's kind of light up here. I think I need more black. I need more black for the darkness of space. You know what? No. We're not going to add more black. We're just going to keep the black that I have. We'll add color. We'll add like some purples and blues and stuff to the tops. To this artsy fartsy space koi painting that we're doing here. I'm just dipping my brush in my water. I'm not adding like a bunch of water to the paint. I'm just dipping it. I'm just dipping it. You know what? I really do need to... Hold on real quick, everybody. I really do need to make it to where I can see your guys' comments. Because I can't see them over here. Let's see here. Let me do that, and then that, and then... Well, bam! Okay. Swirly like Van Gogh. Ooh, you know what I should probably also add in here for all of you nerds? I should add a TARDIS. If there's space koi and we have fish in space, I feel like a TARDIS is gonna be somewhere in the background. Maybe I will add a TARDIS. Along with the fish in space. Because why not? I'm just gonna use up what the blacks that I have right now. Ooh, ready. That's all I'm doing. I'm just gonna use the blacks that I have, and then we'll expand from there. What do you guys think, huh? It's goop.
It's goop.
It's goop.
Alright. I'm being told that the Facebook comments are not showing, but I thought that was Cole earlier from Facebook. I'm not sure. I could have swore. Lissa, I know Lissa's just helping me, troubleshoot. But I could have swore earlier that Cole's was from Facebook, but I could be wrong. So I guess if you want to comment, if you're watching, I'm not really going to be able to see your comments on Facebook, but I should be able to see your comments if you guys swap over to YouTube. Otherwise, leave comments on Facebook and I'll go back and look at them. And, we'll talk about it later. Hi, Chloe. Hi, Chloe. We are taking your idea, Chloe, at yours and Cole's, and we're doing Space Koi with purple swirls and probably some bluish swirls, like a nebula, I'm thinking. And and then I think we're gonna add a TARDIS somewhere in the background for all of you nerds, because I'm a nerd and why not? So yeah, that's yeah. We're gonna add some purples now. I think purple needs to come in now. Purple. We're just painting whatever today. Alright, we're gonna shake up the poiple. Remember everybody, when you get your poiple out, it's gotta be said correctly. Poiple. It's not purple, it's poiple. Alright. Poiple for the people. Purple squirrels. Alright. So all of you watching, if you'd like to do your comments, go on over to YouTube and comment over on the tubes of yous. Otherwise, I can't see your comments, but I will be able to probably comment later after the show for all of you Facebook watchers. And welcome anybody who's watching from Facebook. Otherwise, welcome everybody who's not watching from Facebook. I'm gonna add just a little bit of black. That purple's very, very light poiple. It's a light poiple, so I'm gonna add just a little bit of black. Little bit of black. Little bit of black. I'm gonna make it a dark poiple because it's in space. And we're just gonna swirl it around. Swirl it around. Alright. So let's see if we can make like sort of a nebula, huh? Like a poiple nebula. Like a poiple-ish nebula, huh? I don't know where it's, you know what, there's some blank spots, so I'm gonna start over in these blank spots. We're just gonna see. How do I do swirls with the brush though? Like I guess like that, huh? Ooh, that's doing something. That's doing something. I kind of like what that something is. Dark blue to deepen the purple. Okay, alright. Liz is telling me to add some dark blue to deepen the purple. But I kind of like the... I like how this purple's starting to turn out a little bit. So I'm going to go with this for right now. I might add some blues in on top of this. But I want to fill up some of the space. You know how it is with me, peoples. It's layers. It's all about layers. All right, my son says, okay, Shrek. That's how it should be. Swirl. I'm swirling. Swirling and twirling. Uh-oh. I think I might be eating through my paper. It might be a little too wet. Remember, this is regular copy paper, everybody. That I'm using. I am not using any special kind of canvas or anything like that. I have some, but I'm really hesitant to use it all up. It's mostly my son's, to be honest. Maybe we should let that dry a little bit. Let's let that dry just a smidge. Let's add some more poiples to some of this other areas, though. All right, let's add a little bit of purple swirl down here. And just cover up some of these areas. I really don't know what I'm painting today. This one's gonna be definitely a lot more experimental. You know, like last time I know I wanted to paint the Lonely Mountain and Smaug. Certain comments. Bob Ross, happy trees. Game has that's a very good point. Bob Ross did have happy trees, and Gabe does have layers. Because that's what life is about, everybody. Life is never just one solid thing. It's always about the layers of experiences that we all go through in life. But there's still happy trees. Happy trees, happy swirls, happy layers. Everything is... Gabe has layers. I like that. I like how my new like sort of catchphrase is coming in, just layers. I mean, but that is really what like painting is, seems to be about, right? And life, I guess, if we really want to go that deep into the philosophicalness of what is life and what is painting, but layers and happy trees. I think I'm getting enough purple in here. What do you guys think? Let's just keep the purple that I got there, and let's add some dark blue, and we'll add more. This is just our background. Shake it up.
Shake it up.
Shake up the blue. The azul. For all you Spanish speakers out there, azul. Right? That's blue in Spanish, right? I think it's blue in Spanish. It's azul. Oh, let's see. Blau. Das ist blau auf Deutsch. For all you German speakers out there, das ist blau. All right. We're going to add some. I'm just going to keep the purple. We're just going to add more of the blue into the purple. Add the blue into the purple. And then we're going to add a little bit of a hint of black into that as well. Make a dark blue. Shake it like a Polaroid picture, says Lissa on our archetype. Shake it like a Polaroid picture. And it's not picture, it's picture. Picture. Is that the Klingon way of saying picture? Picture. Kaplop, picture. Man, my nerdiness is really showing through on this one right now. All right, so I'm going to mix the blue, the blue, with the black and the purple. The little bit of purple that's left in there. And that's going to give us another layer, another depth. Some more depth to our space that the koi fish will be swimming on. So I'm thinking, should we do a white koi fish with red and then a red koi fish with white? Should we do that? Like a yin and yangish kind of thing? What do you guys think? I'm just adding some more colors here. Just oh, the music's getting a little somber. Just adding in a little bit. Let the brush do the brushy things. This is how this works, people. You let the brush do the brush. You do the painting. The brush does the brush. I don't know what that means. I'm just rambling. Orange, an orange koi, not a red koi. Sarah says an orange koi, not a red koi. Well, I don't even know if I'm going to be able to do a good koi. So. We'll find out. We'll find out how I do. My Zoidberg. We're going Futurama. For you kids out there, Futurama is not a show for you yet. When you get older, you can watch Futurama and find out who Dr. Zoidberg is. I don't know, this is turning out interesting.
This is definitely going to be an interesting painting. This is definitely going to be an interesting painting. I feel like I'm going to just use up all this blue, and then we'll add. Do we want? I think we want to add the stars before we add the koi. You know, and you know those koi. They're very sneaky, sneaky koi. For all you pun people out there. The light for me is giving me an interesting shimmer. So I kind of, like, I have to move here to see it differently. Huh. Yeah, I know I could do the old toothbrush, but I don't have an old toothbrush. I'm just going to use one of the brushes again. I kind of liked what happened last time with my brushes. It was very just... That's a technical term, by the way, for all you technical people out there. The fla. Remember to make sure that you do the fla technique with your stars. Okay? I mean, people call it the toothbrush or whatever, but I'm going to call it the fla. Because it just sort of flops on there. Alright? That's how we're doing it. That's how these things work out. You know what I'm saying, peeps? I don't know. I think we're almost done with our background of our space. I really want to cover up this up a little bit. This bottom spot. It's very white. Oh, what are we thinking? What are we thinking about this, huh? What are we thinking about this background? This is very interesting background. I feel like my koi are really gonna stand out on this. Like they're gonna pop. You know what I mean? I feel like they're really gonna pop. And the hard part is, I don't know if I'm gonna do them very well. And I want to do two. I was thinking of doing a yin and yang. What do you think? A yin and yang koi in space? In space? In space. Once upon a time in space, there were two koi fish. I'm Sean Connery, and you're welcome to watch Gabriel Cruz paint an Archie Fartsy. Welcome to Archie Fartsy with Gabriel Cruz. Prepare for the layers. Alright. Looks like a deep ocean blue. It does sort of look like a deep ocean-ish sort of, doesn't it? I don't know. It's kind of swirly. I like it to swirls. The problem is, I don't know if I'm going to be very symmetrical with my koi fish. All right. I think that's enough of the background. Yeah, I think that's enough of the background. The back of the round is going to be finished for now. I'm bumping my camera up here. All right. Yeah, sort of like your moon, babe. For all of you who don't know, my girlfriend has the phases of the moons that are going down her back. All right. So I sort of prepared to look at koi fish. I actually have some koi fish on a browser. So I'm going to be kind of looking at that. So that I can try to make sure I get these koi fish as good as possible. As I don't know if I can do koi fish. Alright, so I think I'm going to do one here and make it swirl down this way. And then the other here and swirl up that way. So it's a swirl and a swirl. We got a lot of swirling going on today. A lot of swirling. Oh, wait. I forgot. Stage. We gotta get our stage. Today's Archie Fartsy is brought to you by Sean Connery. Or at least Gabriel Cruz trying to do a Sean Connery impression. Stage before the koi. That sounds like a movie quote. Remember, everybody, it's the stage before the koi. I'm being very goofy today. I got a big glob of white paint on this one. Take that off. All right. Remember to have your shirts you don't care about. Your painted shorts. All right. Put our white. And I'm not going to use a lot, just because. Well, for now, I'm not going to use a lot. So, orange and white. Do we want orange and white, or do we want red and white? That's the question. We're going to leave it up to you. I'm going to leave it up to you people. We're going to do a little poll. So, white. You know, just if you have to, just a W for the white, or a W and R for red and white, or a W and O for red and white and orange. White and orange, or white and red. Which one do you guys want for the koi fish? I know Sarah wanted the orange, but I am very interested to see what you guys. If you have any other colors, you let me know. Remember, we're all in this together. Okay. Gonna do a little dry brush in here. And ready for the flicky. Flicker, flicker, flick, flick, flick. I probably do need a toothbrush. Oh, that didn't work. Nope, that didn't work either. Whip it. Nope, that's still not working. We gotta do the flicky flick. Ooh, that one looked cool. There it comes, the sound effects, everybody. Alright, I want another big splotchy like that one. That one, I like that splotchy right there. That one. I like the little stars. I don't like the big, like, I like the little stars. Alright, here we go. Let's do it this way. Let's do it this way. Kabaya! Oh, I think I'm gonna take this and we're gonna do. Just a, like there's stuff in the background. I don't know. I'm goofing off. Clusters of stars. Yeah, alright. Alright, stars are there. Time for the fishies. Right? Fishies? Da fishies? Time for the fish. Alright, so Sarah says orange and white. Chloe says orange and red. Ugh. I don't know, you might be taking my painting skills a little too far there, Chloe. And then, Lissa says white and orange. So far, I've got white and orange. That's three out of the two people watching. So, you know, we're doing white and orange. White and orange it is. White and orange for the fish. For the fish. Alright. The question is, how do I start this? This one should be the white fish with little hints of orange, and this one should be the orange fish with little hints of white. I think that's what we're going to do. I really wish I had some way. Like, there's okay. So, I don't know if some of you people might know this, but like in photography and in I guess in painting, I haven't really used it a lot in painting, but in painting and in film and stuff like that, there's this thing called the golden ratio. So, I really wish I had a line that went across here and here. And then one here and here and then there and there, so I can find where the golden ratio is, because it should be there and it should be there. I think, I don't know, we're gonna do this. Paint the curves of the body first. Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
I'm gonna do All right, let's start with the orange. I think the orange. We shook it up. We shook up the orange like a Polaroid pic top. All right. I'm gonna need a brush that I know I can really manipulate. And I think, should we do a bright orange or a darker orange? No, koi fish would be a brighter orange, I guess. Mike, what's up, buddy? All right. I think we're gonna have to do. I gotta try this. I'm so nervous. I am nervous right now because I haven't done fishies. Not like this. Not in painting. I could probably do a fishy drawing. Because I'd have the ability to erase. Okay. I need to look at this a little bit straighter. I'm so nervous to do this. Because this is different from my usual, like, if I mess up, oh well. It's gonna be like a teardrop. I just want to do the teardrop. That's what I need to do. I need to do the teardrop. Right here. All right, here we go. Oh, I miss Darwin. How's he doing? Mike's talking about one of our old mentors and one of the dolly grips in the industry. I'm sort of sketching. If anybody out there knows how to sketch, this is what I'm ending up doing. I'm sort of sketching it. Gonna be interesting. I think when I start adding more into it, it'll fill itself out. So there's where the tail will go, right there. This is definitely interesting. All right, there's where the first one will be. We're gonna start with that, just so I know where it's at. That's the first fish. So the second fish, I guess I could have gone a little bit deeper, but just to keep symmetry, I'm gonna do the next one right here. Not so it's sort of a yin and yang, sort of. It's not 100%. Oh, I guess I could bring this down a little bit further and use this as something. Oh, my nerves are kicking in. My perfectionist in me is kicking in. Not good. All right, let's do the other one right here. It's sort of a yin and yang. Dice rolly box thingamajig. Oh, for like D&D and stuff. For the dungeons and the dragons. A dice roll box. Those are always nice. Those are cool. Especially you put a little felt in them. And then the dice don't clank around so much. Alright, a little bit of white. Here we go. A little bit of white for the bottom fish. The bottom fish. And remember, I gotta try to keep it as symmetrical as possible. So this one, I guess that's my halfway point, right? So I need to come up just a little bit. Oh man, you guys are seeing me in a vulnerable state right now when I'm painting. Nemo! Space Nemo! Alright, here we go. Here comes the other fish. The other space fish. Thank you. feels somber.
Okay, all right, now we need to curve it.
I really am more sketching than I am anything else right now.
Yeah, I'm more sketching. My instincts, my old school sketching instincts are kicking in. And I am more of a sketch artist than I am a painter. I could sketch, but I take a long time when I sketch. That's the problem. Because I can erase, and I can definitely fix mistakes when I sketch. You know what? This ain't turning out to be that bad. The space koi. I can always extend this out more, and I can extend that out more. I think that's it. I think that's where my feces are. What do you guys think, huh? That's starting to look like something. Yeah, I'm looking at it. Yeah. Okay, all right. Let's, before I get too much further in that, I think I'm gonna add the whiskers that come off. The picture that I'm looking at, these guys have long whiskers. So I'm gonna have the whiskers come almost like catfish. I guess those are sort of like catfish. Are koi fish like catfish? The ones I'm looking at, then, that's what it looks like. So, gonna have that coming off. Then we'll have the fin come off the back. The fin doesn't go all the way down, so it goes from about there. Then we have the really long whiffy tail. We'll have the whiffy tail come off there, like that. And then we have the two fins, and then the small little fin on the inside. Okay. All right. And then for this fish, I'm gonna do orange swoops. We'll do orange swoops for the scales. We'll do orange swoops for the scales on this one, and we'll do white swoops for the scales on this one. Should we keep it like opaque like this? Transparent, sorry. Should we keep it transparent where you can see the stars underneath? I don't know. We'll find out. This is looking pretty. Mood, dude. Okay, yeah. Okay. I think this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna do this one's whiskers real quick. Their noses are a lot more. I think their faces needed to be a little bit more like poof, like not as rounded as I have them. I don't know, but we're just, you know, we're playing with it. We're seeing how it goes. This is how this works, because it's artsy fartsy, right? Perfection is not the goal. Fun is the goal. Fun and layers. If you have a lot of layers of fun, everything is good. Just with this, it looks weird. Looks a little weird to me. That's okay. All right, let's get this fin. There's a fin here. I don't know how this is looking. I guess the other fin would be here. I guess we could flare this out a little bit like that. You guys are gonna have to tell me how this is looking to you, because I'm feeling very nervous about this. This is the first time I've actually been kind of nervous about what I'm painting. I guess because I'm looking at a reference. I haven't really done a reference before. I really need to make this guy's tail in the fin. I really need to make the tail. There's a little fin here, that's for sure. Just like that. And then I'm gonna do a fluffy tail. Maybe his tail, you know, I think we'll have his tail go off the page. And I think we'll add... I don't know. I really am feeling kind of more nervous about this one. Oh, man. Oh, well. You know what? I don't know. It's coming along. It's coming along. I should quit doubting myself. I'm doubting myself right now. That's the problem. That's really what's happening. Let's get to his fin here. It's going to come up and over. Like this. But then it trails along his back. So I want it to trail along his back like that. And then it comes into himself. That's what the painting is that I'm seeing. So, or the picture. I don't know if it's really a painting. It looks more like a sketch. But this thing's got some very interesting flows to it. Well, I'm glad you love the tail. I'm glad you love the tail, Chloe. This music's making me feel a little bit more inspired. Extend out his thing there. All right. I think I'm gonna stop there on that fish. Just for now. I know we need the... There's a lot more. I still have to do, like... I don't know if I should do black... I mean, the eyes are already sort of included here. But... I don't know. We'll see. We'll see. Maybe the eyes will be orange. I'm glad you guys are liking it. Okay. So, we'll do the orange one now. Do the orange fish. And then we'll add his orange scales. We'll do his orange scales, and then I'll probably add some accents of the orange into here, just to. I kind of like the starryness like seeping through them. So let's get our orange. Let's get our orange. Our orange. Ooh, we got 7 viewers. Hello, 7 people. I know some of you. I don't know all of you, but welcome. We are doing Space Koi. Maybe a little TARDIS in the background. Because why not? The doctor, I'm sure, definitely loves his koi fish. His fish. All right, let me get that same brush. I gotta wipe that off. Move this mouse out of the way. This has been my precision brush today. All right, let's paint. So we're going to do the same thing on this guy. The same exact thing we just did with this. All right, and I got my orange. I'm going to start with his whiskers. Just because that's where I started last time, and I feel like that was an okay move. This music is a lot more uplifting, so I like this music a little better than what I was listening to earlier, because I was feeling very nervous a little bit earlier. I feel like I have more control going flip it that way. Somebody asked for fish, so we're doing fish. Space Koi.
Koi in space.
Can anybody tell me why they're called koi? I'm just curious. I do not know. I don't know. I was wondering if there was something maybe in Japanese, they're an Asian fish. I know that, but I do not know the history of the koi. All right, there's those whiskers. Now let's do his fins. Should be about right here. Going up than I do the down. I don't know, this fin seems a little, maybe because I'm getting more used to how it should look. Alright, we're gonna do his scales after we're done with these fins. With our space koi, our space species. Not good food. I don't know, I've never had. Has anybody ever eaten koi? I've never eaten koi. I almost feel like this, that's a question for my foodies out there, Sarah. Did somebody give me a link for fishies? All right. The little fin. I need the little fin. The little fin. All right, now for the tail. The swishy tail. Well, somebody said something about a tail. What did somebody say, Sarah? Should make the side fin look more like the tail than the top fin. Those look really cool. Oh, yes. Okay, so I'm presuming just replicate this on top of that is what you're saying. That's what I was planning on doing. So we're going to do that. Now here we go. All right, so first is the tail. I need a swishy tail. Man, how did I do this before I went? Let's come out a little bit further on that one. Like that. Yeah. Yeah. A little bit more fishy. Okay. One a little bit nicer than the white one, but then again, it is kind of its own little contrast. All right, now the fin needs to be about here, so curl that in with the body. I have the fin in the middle of here first, so let me do that. I need to go in the middle of here. Let me curve it in to the rest of the body. Yeah. hide that line. That line that's behind it, I kind of want to hide it just so it makes it look like it blends. What do we think? Huh? The space koi so far? This is definitely a different picture than the one I was thinking. I didn't think I'd be doing this today, people. To be honest, I really didn't. Thank you, Chloe. Okay, so I think I'm gonna stop there for that, but I'm gonna do the orange scales on this one and white scales on this one. And that's just gonna be, we're just gonna do little humps. I'm just gonna do little humps as little humps. I kind of like this transparent thing going on here. Kind of adds to like the mysticism, I guess you could say, of Defiche. So we're gonna do little orange curves right here, little orange scales. I'm questioning if I should do like the nose and the eyes of the fish, the different color. What do you guys think, huh? We're just gonna go down. We're just gonna do the scales just as we go. This shouldn't take that long for the scales, because it's just little U humps, I guess you could call them. This music's making me feel weird. I need to switch the music. I feel weird with this music. This music's special. That's a little bit more upbeat. The upbeat music is helping me. You guys should paint this and upload it. I need more people painting. I really do. I wanna see what other people come up with, because, you know, it's one thing, you know, the whole thing about Bob Ross was when he was painting it, he wanted other people to paint. And that's sort of what I want people to do. I want people to paint their own things.
She knows this.
You know?
She obsesses.
I want to see your versions of it. I want to see what you guys come up with. Catherine and Isaac. I might even have, I'll challenge my son to make this. Maybe he can animate it. What do you guys think, huh? I kind of like the orange. I almost feel like I want to do the nose. I kind of want to do the nose and the eyes now. Oh, I got a little smudged. It's okay though. We're just having fun, right?
Trying out, but it's easy to see that. Well, she's not the only one. She's not the only one.
I feel like I need to get smaller.
You've got those bright eyes.
I'm gonna need to blow my nose to get it a little bit.
Through mine. I'm trying to figure out if there's any more doubt in my mind.
I don't know if I'm doing okay on this end part. My loopies are not getting very loopy. I think the brush is just too thick. It's okay though. We're getting this done. The scale should technically, like if you were doing like the scale, they should get smaller. Don't make it the focus. Yeah, that's what I was thinking. It should just be there.
She thinks she's the only one who goes crazy. Picks up the phone when she thinks she heard it ring.
think I have a smaller brush. I don't have a smaller brush that can really do the detail that I want. There we go. Okay, let's do the two little nosy marks, which are near the whiskers. Two little nosy marks right one here and one here. And then we have the eyes. So I'm gonna do the eyes. The eyes are kinda how we get here. Feels like 10 years. This is a very special coin. There we go. I think I might take like a black or something in the middle of this, or a white, and just make like a slit for the eye. But yeah. Okay, and you know what? I think while I still have the orange, I'm gonna do some orange accents on these. Just to add to where. I don't know, some sort of another layer, if you will. Let's add some to the tail. What do you think? Huh? What do we think? Mike, I will book you for next Friday. How's that sound? I want to have some other guests. I definitely want to have some other guests, buddy. So if you want, why don't you and Chloe join me next Friday? I will book you guys for next Friday. I need to take a quick break. I'm going to mute myself for just a minute so you don't hear the nose trumpet. All seven of you. I am going to blow my nose. Because it is. My nose is stuffy today. I'll be right back as far as this thing goes. Admire the painting. Not just ogres that have layers. It's happy trees that have layers. Alright. Okay, time for the white. Time for the white on the coin. What time are we at? 8 o'clock. I think we have enough time to finish the white on the orange coin. And we might have enough time to get a little tiny TARDIS in there. For our nerd friends. Okay. All right, so on this part it's just the loopies. It's the loopies. The scales. Oh, see, I'm so much better at painting this part for some reason. I don't know. I feel like I fumbled through the bottom one and then oh man, these are big scales. Oh man, these scales are big. Never mind. I spoke too soon. I was having some precision. Those scales are special. I don't care what you say they are. I think I just had too much paint. I had too much paint. That's what it was. I recognize what my mistakes are. Well, that one. That scale. That was definitely special. All right, let's start making these. Let's start making these look a little nicer. Nope. I really spoke too soon. I don't know. Still looks nice. Still having fun. You guys should definitely be painting along. I know I have one family that supposedly this is their dinner entertainment.
Sarah.
You should please send me their versions. I want to see everybody's versions. Because it would be fun.
I'm getting a thingy. Oh, my son has sent something, probably an animation to my sister.
My son does a lot of animations. Again, if we can get 100 likes on a video, I will share my son's animations with you guys.
That wasn't an animation, that was a time lapse.
Oh, a time lapse. I'll share some of my son's artsy fartsy stuff with you guys. If I can get 100 likes on a video, we got hashtag goals. Hashtag goals.
Says Chloe and Mike are cooking.
They're cooking?
Mm-hmm.
That's another type of artsy fartsiness.
Cooking.
Yep. I don't know. This fish is getting a few more scales, I feel like.
Let me see.
Ooh. Oh, that one.
Noise. Hold on.
Uh-huh. Noise. Yep. Okay. I'm losing control on this one. This one's scales are not as nice as I'd like it, but that's okay. I could always go back in with a little bit of darkish bluish black to touch on stuff, but you know, I got limited time, so. See, it's like I start off good and then I get too wide on the brush. That's the problem. I'll have to get that for you later, buddy. If you want to watch TV, you're going to have to go downstairs. Yeah. All right. It's modern art, Gabe. Yes, that's all this is. It's true. Yin and yang doesn't have to be the same. Should technically be opposites. But I don't want this to be pretty and that to be ugly. Oh man, I feel like I am messing up on this one. I feel like that turned out a little bit prettier, but maybe because I made the loops a little bit bigger. My brush is starting to fray on me a little. Not fray, but like, it's not as precise as it was before. Either that, or, you know, I'm just blaming the brush. I'm blaming the brush. It's all the brush's fault. It's not my fault. It's not my fault. I didn't do it. It is my fault. I'm the painter. Ah, it's okay. It's okay. It's okay, Gabe. Don't be self-conscious. Just enjoy the paint. Let the brush do the brushy things. You enjoy what you're doing. This is the mantra. It's starting to look better toward the back there, I think. Could be speaking too soon again. Yeah, so let me see your koi fish when you guys make them. Your space koi. I'm glad you guys are stuck with me. I got 19 minutes to finish this up. I really want to have enough time to put a TARDIS in. A tiny little TARDIS. There is a painter. There was a painter that inspired Catherine, my girlfriend's daughter's painting that she made me of like these trees. It was this guy kept doing all these different scenes And then he kept adding in a happy little TARDIS. That's what he called him, too. As far as I remember, from what I was told. The scales definitely got better as we went. Okay, time to add the little nosy things. And then the eyes. I've been kind of doing this little oval thing with the eyes. And I wanted to do a slit in the orange ones, so I'm going to do a little bit of paint at the end of my brush. And I'm just going to put a little slit, if I can, right down the middle there. Yeah. All right. What do we got here? Somebody for the... So... My beard was showing? Is it my beard? Right here? It is probably my beard that's showing. Right where you guys' comments is going. You guys can see where my brush and my palette are right now? You guys, that's what I was looking for, the word earlier, palette. You guys can put all your comments show up in that area, which is a lot of fun. All right, time to add the white accents like I did the orange accents. To our space koi. I don't know. I think this has turned out interesting. Interesting because, again, I didn't expect that I would be doing space fish. I really didn't expect I was going to do space fish. I know next week I want to do something nerdy again. I like doing nerdy things. I guess space fish is pretty nerdy. Like, who really does space fish, huh? Who puts fish in space? Where did I have that? That one's just the inside and... Okay. Thank you, Chloe. I don't know what I want to do next week. Somebody told me I should do some Harry Potter and some Quidditch. That was one of my relatives. I know if I do that, Lissa's definitely going to be interested, and so are Sarah and her kids, because it's Harry Potter and they're huge Harry Potter fans. I might do a Quidditch towers, like a I'm thinking a Quidditch match or Quidditch thing, not necessarily the Hogwarts Quidditch stadium, but like a private stadium or something, and then showing some people playing Quidditch, do some towers and stuff. That's what I was thinking in my head. You guys tell me what you think. Somebody else said I should do more ocean stuff. People really like fishies for some reason. And I'm really interested. I don't know if you guys saw the Lonely Mountain I did. I uploaded it with the 3D application. Doctor Who did put a whale in space. But what was I saying? I don't even remember what I was saying now. Oh, my train of thought got lost. Harry Potter. Okay, we might do Harry Potter next. I think we're going to do Harry Potter next week. Lissa, if you're still there, looks like it's going to be Harry Potter. Going to have to inform your entire clan of your of those people that you, what do you call it, your houses and your Harry Potter group. We're doing Harry Potter next week. I think I'm gonna do a Quidditch stadium. Cause I mean I could technically do I could technically do Hogwarts again like I did on the drawing, but that took me way too long on the drawing. Like I took a good like 5-6 days of just dedicated drawing. Let's make this eye a little longer. There. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, I think that's good. That's good. That's good. Okay, I want to put a little orange slit in those. I might have a little bit of paint left that's orange paint that's still wet in my palette. But I need to rinse off my brush. The brush must be washed from the white paint. Chloe just, I guess, friend me on the Facebook, on the Facebook. Just friend me, and you can just scroll down my thing. There's Lissa's got, I think Lissa, our head of marketing, is posting them up on our Instagram and stuff now, so, you can find our Instagrams and things that way as well. I can't do, like, big locations at Harry Potter yet. Not at the speed that I'm going. All right, orange slits in the eyes. That's what we're doing right now. Still using that same brush, but I'm going to do orange slits in the eyes for this one. There we go. There it is. There's our space fish. Our space koi. All right, what time are we at? 8:19. I have 11 minutes to try to put a TARDIS in here. I think I need to look up a picture of a TARDIS. Because I'm probably going to get it wrong if I don't. TARDIS. Not the color. I need the TARDIS. And switch. I need a reference on these people, okay? I'm cheating. I'm looking at a picture of a pic. I'm going to make a picture of a picture. Okay. I know it's just a little box, but... All right. There's just something about it. I need to look at it in order to make sure I'm not completely messing it up. It's just how I I'm getting nervous about this. The pictures are expanding. Okay. All right. Let's put a little TARDIS in here somewhere. Where should we put it, though? That's the next question. Should I put it over here? Or should I put it over here? Here or here? Right or left? Oh, man. Where should I put this? I think I'm going to put it over here. On top of these stars, maybe? Maybe the stars will help pop it a little more. Alright, so we're just going to use blue. And we're going to do a little box-looking thing. And then we're going to add its little windows in the top lantern. I feel that's what we're going to do. Because I don't have a reference for where light's coming from. Because these space koi are just magically mystic. They're just appearing out of nowhere. So, yeah. Yeah, so we're just going to use a regular blue. I'm not going to try to actually match the true TARDIS blue, because I feel like I'm definitely going to mess up on that if I do. And I need to do a box. Let me see if I can find a brush that will help me a little bit more than the last one. That last one will probably be best for doing the windows. Oh, I'm doing a TARDIS. This is making me nervous again. All right, I'm going to try this brush. No, that's too big. It's too big. I don't want that big of a TARDIS. I want a smaller TARDIS. Maybe this one? We'll see. We'll see. All right. Let's see if I can get a box here. I'm going to wet that brush a little bit. Give a little bit more control. Let's see. All right. Okay. I need to do the box. I'm going to do the outline first. Before I fill it in. Our TARDIS people. I'm gonna make it a little longer. For those of you who don't know what a TARDIS is, it is a time traveling device, time and space traveling device in the Doctor Who series, which has been going on, sort of a science fiction history fantasy series that has been going on since the 1960s 50s 58. I could be wrong. Lissa would definitely be able to look that up for me real quick if she's still available, but the Doctor Who series has been going on for a very long time, and it really got more popular probably about, let's say, about 10 years ago. There's our happy little TARDIS over here. That's not too bad. All right, I'm going to fill it in with the rest of the blue, and then I'm going to add the windows. So we're going to cover up some of our stars, but that's okay. Probably take a little bit of black to give me some lines, because it's kind of hard to see the lines on this. Then again, it is kind of blending. A little space TARDIS observing our magical space fish. That's what this is. The Doctor has heard that there are magical space fish that appear once every millennia, and he wanted to see them. I don't know which companion he took with him. Could be Rose. Could be a few other different companions, but yes. Oh, you told me to do it over here, Sarah. I started it down here on the way. It's too late. I already made a decision. Love you. All right, I think I had a little bit too much blue in there. This in my tray, that blue's probably gonna get wasted a little bit. But I'm gonna take some black, and I'm gonna draw a little bit of the lines so I can see where my TARDIS's features are. Sorta. A little bit of black. Just a dot. There we go. This is your favorite painting so far, Chloe? Thank you. All right, I wanted it to be the top. This brush is good. I should have used this brush for the scales. I'm just recognizing that right now. Totally should have used this brush for the scales. I totes should have used this brush for the scales. This brush is working really well for my more specific lines. It's the number 3 brush? I'm not really familiar too much with numbers on brushes. Not like my pencils. All right,
Time to add the little bit of white. What are we at? Oh, 3 minutes. I got 3 minutes. 3 minutes, people. 3 minutes to add the TARDIS windows. Just a little blob of white. Yeah, I'm digging this music, man. This one, this right here. Very techno-y. Alright. Here we go for the windows. Oh no. There's supposed to be two windows. I don't know if I'm going to be able to... There's a little lantern on the top too. Alright, there's our happy little TARDIS. It's kind of a messy TARDIS, but it'll do. Alright, that's it. That's it. I don't think I have time to really correct anymore. 2 minutes. Oh, I might be able to correct a little bit more on the TARDIS. Whew. I'm pushing it, though. I'm pushing it. Let's see if I can get a little black in between the windows. Oh man. Okay, that's it. That's it. That's enough. No more. That is all. There we go. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, pickles, beef, milk, whatever, everybody out there, cabbage, tomatoes, everybody, the space koi with a TARDIS, with a happy little TARDIS. The space koi. Yes, this has been fun. This has been interesting. The story behind this, I don't know. The Doctor Who showed up to look at the magical space koi, apparently. I hope everybody's enjoyed this episode. And thank you, everybody, for tuning in. This is great. We have 6 viewers today. Last time, we only had about 3. We are growing in viewership. Send everybody over. Let me see your space koi and your space fish. Okay, everybody, I really want to see what you guys got and what everybody else can put together. This is, you know, because life is layers. You know, every layer happens every day of our lives. I guess that's my new catchphrase, because Chloe was saying that I talk about layers a lot, just like Bob Ross talked about happy trees. But these are our happy space koi and our happy little TARDIS down here. And I think that's it for me for tonight. But, last time, some of you stuck around for a little bit longer and you got a sneak peek before I posted the picture of a close-up of everything. So you never know. If you stay, there might be a little after show of the picture. All right? Otherwise... thank you, everybody, for joining in with Artsy Fartsy Friday. We will see you guys next week. Remember to like, subscribe, all the doodly doodads. Send it out to your friends. Let me see your space fish, and let's see what we do next week, which is looking like it'll be some Harry Potter. I'm Gabriel Cruz, and I'll see you guys later. Thank you.
you guys are still here. All right, since you guys are still here, again, you guys stay. All five of you stayed. So you know what we're gonna do? I'm gonna take the camera off of this. I'll switch over to it. Switch over to the other angle, and I will show you guys. But I think we'll just do the easel this time. I'm not gonna do the little. You know what? We'll just go with it. All right, here we go. All right, so you guys stayed, so you get to see the space coin, everything up front before the pictures come out. So I gotta take this camera off, which is just technically my phone. Here's our little TARDIS. It looks a little jiggy up close. Look at that little guy. Oh my gosh. but these are the space fish. So here's our orange one. And we'll come down to our yin and our yang and our white one. A little fish of the tail. I don't know. What are you, a rating for adults? What do you mean rating for adults? Like, what are you adults rated as? I don't know. What do you think? Like, I don't know. I like some of this. Some of this stuff looks very nebula to me, especially on camera. And then you have like the stars that just sort of blend. I don't know. I like this. This was fun. Like everything else that I've been painting lately, this has been fun. This has been a lot of fun. Janky TARDIS for the win. Yes, definitely a janky TARDIS. Look at that guy. Whew. Oh man, TARDIS was feeling a little special. Oh man, all right. Well, that's it, guys. You guys sticked around, so you guys got to see everything a little bit up close before the pictures come out. Look for the 3D one, because I've been doing that too. Like, there's been 3D. Like, as soon as the picture comes out, what'd you call it? The Lonely Mountain one had a 3D version on Facebook, which looked really cool. So I'm kind of interested to see how this is going to turn out in 3D, with the distance and the popping and like the being able to move it. So we'll see. We'll see what it looks like. Otherwise, you guys, thank you once again for joining in. I'm glad you guys had fun. I had fun. Again, let me see what you guys got. Let's do some Harry Potter next week, huh? Harry Potter. Harry Potter painting next week. I think we're going to do some Quidditch. And we're going to have Mike White and Chloe. Chloe Kuffler? Kuffler? I probably am butchering your last name. If that is your last name, I am sorry. But Chloe and Mike will be joining me next week on Artsy Fartsy Friday. And I'm looking forward to see what you guys got. Thank you once again. Thank you, Alyssa, for being my troubleshooting and I guess technically helping me produce this one. But we'll see you guys on the next one, definitely. Now I'm actually saying good night.